Okay, so now what we're going to do is let's go ahead and start the manufacturing assembly, our manufacturing application. So we'll go to application, manufacturing, and the first time we go into the manufacturing application inside of this model, it's going to ask us about the machining environment. I tend to go with CAM General, first of all, and then mill contour. That's kind of my generic go-to choice, and that should work fine for this. All right, so now we are in the manufacturing application, and remember, here's your operation navigator. Over here on this side, you need to pay careful attention to this. This is where all of your manufacturing related operations are going to go, and related information. This new tab is kind of your go-to place. Notice that this one tab has four different views that will tell you different things depending on how you look at it. So you can right click on this thing and get the program order view, or the machine tool view, the geometry view, or the method view. All right, so we're going to start with the inside the geometry view, and we want to go ahead and get this all set up. All right, so first of all, the most important thing out of all of this, first of all, is to get our MCS set up properly. This is going to be where our G54 is going to go in. Okay, so we're going to position our origin and the orientation of our axes for what's going to become our G54 position. Let's see. So for this assignment, let's place it here at the corner of the place it at the corner of the vise there. That's a pretty simple way to do it. We can do it without our workpiece being placed in there, and that's going to work pretty fine. So you'll see that it's not actually finding that edge yet, and that's because we filtered just to inside the work part, and our work part is just a big old assembly. The only thing we have inside the work part is maybe a datum CSS or something in there. So we want to come out here and look in the entire assembly. That will allow us to snap to that origin there. All right, now what's wrong with this picture? That is that our x-axis is not oriented properly. Okay, so we want this x-axis to be lined up with this side of the vise, and now everything looks right. Our z-axis is up and down the way it is on the machine. Our x-axis left and right, our y-axis in and out, and that's what we the way we want it. All right, let me do something here real quickly. Let me just edit this since I have it in the right place. I'm going to edit it, and what I need to do is come in here and open up the offsets. Now, what I'm going to tell you is not going to apply to pretty much anyone else's way of doing things in the real world. Normally, this fixture offset, since it's going to become in our machine is going to know it as G55. A lot of machines would want that to be fixture offset number two. They start at fixture offset number one with G54, and then 55 is number two, and so on. However, the way our post processor works, took the easy way out. It's going to take and put a G in front of whatever the fixture offset is, and it's no, well, not 55. We want it to be, in this case, G55. Okay, so this G55 is, we're going to name it G55, and that way when our post processor sees it, it will set us up in G55. Don't put G in there. The post processor will put G in there. We're going to call it fixture offset 55. But like I said, don't expect anybody else in the world to do it that way. We'll say okay. All right, now we need to come in here and set up our workpiece geometry. First of all, notice that it is inheriting from our MCS mill. That is not a trivial thing. That's something that has to happen. Okay, this whole idea of inheritance is something you should always be paying careful attention to in the manufacturing application inside of NX. So let's come in here and we'll edit this workpiece. We'll say right-click edit, and we need to specify the part. That's going to be this piece inside of here. This is the mold cavity side. So let me just hit that. That's what we want. then we're going to specify the blank. That's going to be this outside. Make sure that you're getting the right pieces for this, or else you're going to have trouble later on. And then we can assign this device as check geometry if you want to. We don't want to. I'm not going to worry about that too much right now, but go ahead and say that. All right, say OK there. All right, so let's see. Now we need to create, well, that's basically it for the manufacturing setup. Let me go ahead and we'll go ahead and create a tool, because this is the kind of stuff that you're going to just do over and over and over again, and then we'll get started. So let me first create a tool. And in this case, we're going to make it our 2-inch facing tool. Yeah, we can use a period now. Older versions of NX won't allow us to do that. And we don't want spaces in there. But we have our 2-inch facing mill. Then we'll say OK. Subtype is just this plain old mill. That'll be fine. All right. And then the diameter of that thing is 2 inches. Let me go grab the spreadsheet where I should actually be pulling this information from. Hang on just a sec. Okay, so this is the tool number assignments. There's a link to this spreadsheet on the assignment. Don't use the values in the video that you're watching right now. Use the values on this actual spreadsheet in case anything changes. Do pay attention to any of the notes that are on here. There's several that make a pretty big difference. So take time and make sure that you look at those carefully. I just messed that up. Okay. So it's a 2-inch diameter. The lower radius, as far as we're concerned here, is going to go ahead and be 0. There is actually a tiny radius, but we do get 2 inches of sweep out of that thing, more or less. Let's see. The flute length, here we want to use 50 thou. Which seems like it's pretty small, but I don't want you guys making very big cuts with this thing. In fact, I don't want you to make anything more than a 20 thou depth of cut. I asked for 30 thou as a max depth of cut for that. So 30 thou, that's fine. So we'll go with that. These feed rates are extraordinarily conservative. Go ahead and use those, but expect when you do calculated values to get much faster feed rates than these. So these are nice and conservative for educational purposes. All right, so let me go in here. Let's see, we got 3 inches. This is going to be tool number one. Okay, tool number one, and we'll use adjust register one. Cutcom register 1. So just make all of those 1. We shouldn't be using cutter compensation inside of this, but I just like to make all of these the correct tool number. It is vital that you get that right. Okay, so when you come in here to make the other tools, I'm not going to show you how to make each individual one. You'll need to be able to do that. It is essential, though, that you name them the right thing and that they get called out in the tool numbers down here properly. All right, so we'll say OK to that. All right, so that sets us up. Now we can go in and just start making some operations, and I'm going to break those out separately, so I'm going to kill it here.